I believe. Because beside you. If you're expecting him for something, if you're expecting him for a great miracle, don't just stand there with your eyes wide open, but just close your eyes and lift your hands this morning. Come expecting. The reason why we come in and we leave the same way we came in is because we don't come with an expectant heart. Just open your hearts up this morning. Open your hearts up this morning. Lift your hands and worship him. Join in the worship. Thank you for your presence.
Yeah.
for sending your only begotten Son, who you love so much. Lord, that proves how much you love me. That proves how much you really love us. Lord, you give us worth. You give us worth. You gave us worth. As you're in this atmosphere this morning, just know that you have worth. Just know that you are worth something. You are worth something. Not just because I'm telling you, but because the Lord thought it so. Because God thought that you are worth something. You are worth so much that He sent His only begotten Son for you. He came down and died for you.
Of Christ. I thank you, God. Oh God, empty me out this morning. refreshment in our lives. Hallelujah. Amen. And simply meaning divine means from God. Amen. Amen. We receiving what God has in store for us. Amen. And we want what God wants for us. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Amen. I want what God wants for me. Praise God. And this is going to happen because you choose to partner with God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Lift your hands and say this after me. Declare this in the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you that in my year of 2022, that you will grant me favor. Favor with God and favor with men. I decree and I declare that the blessing of the Lord will surround me. Oh, hallelujah. I thank you for your favor. Will surround me like a shield in this year. I thank you. Your favor is upon my life. I thank you, God. Make my mountain stand strong by your favor. Because of your favor, the enemy will not triumph over me. Through your favor, I am brought back from captivity. Let my horn be exalted through your favor. My set time of favor has come. My set time of favor has come. My set time of favor has come. I entreat your favor with my whole heart. Let your favor be as a cloud of the latter rain in my life. In Jesus' mighty name, I believe it, I receive it, I decree it, I declare it, I'm going after it. In Jesus' mighty name, give God a shout of praise. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Amen. And I believe that we're going to see the hand of the Lord in the land of the living. Praise God. And I believe that this is a year of full accomplishment, of divine accomplishment in your life, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you so much. Praise the name of Jesus. And so we're gonna have to move in 2022 with purpose. Praise God. It is no more time to be on the fence and complaining. It is time to move with purpose. You are alive because God has a plan and a purpose for your life. And then 2022 is assigned to purpose-driven people. And then are you a part of the company of people that are on purpose, with purpose, doing things with purpose? Amen. You got to be doing things for God in this year with purpose. Many times you've been doing things for God and we have just been doing it because, oh, we think it's the right thing to do, or because somebody told us to do it, and yet we have not been doing it with purpose. May you do things in your 2022 year with purpose, in Jesus' mighty name. Now, Father, we believe that God is going to do great and mighty things in this year. In the name of Jesus, I firmly believe that we've got to position ourselves for great expectation from the Lord this year. Hallelujah. I firmly believe that. Amen. Tell your neighbor, position yourself for expectation. Come and say, position yourself for great expectation from the Lord. Amen. Because what's going to happen in 2022, it's going to be the planting of the Lord. It's not going to be by man. It's not going to be by any a manager or supervisor or anything. It's going to be by God. Amen. Amen. This is a God movement. Say, neighbor, it is a God movement. Okay? It's a God movement. So you either moving with the Spirit of the Lord or you moving with the cloud that's going nowhere. Amen. I'm choosing my 2022 as this is the first Sunday of the year. I choose to move with God. I choose to move with the leading and the guiding and the direction of the Holy Spirit, because I don't want to miss what God is doing in this hour. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. And I firmly believe that we are going to do great exploits for the kingdom of God. The Bible says that we will do great exploits for the kingdom. Amen. Praise the name of Jesus. Now, I just want you to do a bit of some teaching to you this morning to give you some understanding of what the year 2022 simply mean. So if you're taking your notes, God bless you. Amen. According to the Hebrew calendar, we are in the year of 5782. 5782. Okay? Right? And I want to share with you the significance of 5782. So what is 5 plus 7? What is 8 plus 2? What is 10 plus 12? So in the year of 20, come on somebody. Okay, sometimes we don't understand these things because we don't take time to study. All right, so I've got to teach you what we are doing is according to the word of God, because we don't follow the Roman Catholicism or the Roman calendar. All right, praise God. Amen. Praise the Lord. Okay, so when we look at that, we look at the number 5 speaks of grace. Right? The number 5 speaks of grace. The number 7 speaks of perfection. Right? And the number 8 speaks of new beginnings. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. And the number 2 speaks of double portion. Come on, somebody. So when you break the numbers up, this is what God is saying for your year of 2022 of divine accomplishments to this house. Amen. Because why? The grace of the Lord is sufficient for you, and God is going to perfect that which concerns you. Amen. And God is going to do a new beginning in your life. Why? Because we are in a new era. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. And what you're going to see is a double portion of what? Of God's glory. Hallelujah. Come on, this is a young devil. Amen. Amen. The Lord says He bestow double honor upon you. Amen. May you receive double honor in this year. Amen. May you receive double increase. May you receive double wisdom, double understanding, double revelation, double understanding of God's word and His glory in your life. Hallelujah. We're going to see a double glory coming to the earth like never before. Because the Bible says in the book of Habakkuk chapter 2 verse 14, the Bible says, for the earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the glory of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Bible says in the book of Romans chapter 8, for this affliction is just but for a moment. You're going to go through some afflictions in this season and in this year. But I'm going to say to you, it's just going to be but for a moment. So you don't set up camp in the midst of your valley. Your valleys are meant for you to go through. Amen. Say, neighbor, go through. Go through your process. Amen. Things are going to come and distract you. Things are going to come and try and twist the truth. Amen. Is that according to the word of God concerning your life, what the word of God is concerning your family, your home. Amen. And what God has spoken over your life concerning you. Amen. But we are standing with the word of God. We are standing on the promises of God. Amen. And we believe that what God has promised for our lives in this year, amen, hell cannot stop what God wants to do in your life, in your home, in your family, in your situation, in our community, in our country, in the entire world. Amen. Glory to Jesus. The Bible says the earth shall be filled with what? The knowledge of the glory of the Lord. So this affliction is just but for a moment, but it says, which cannot be compared to the glory of the Lord. That's verse 18 of Romans chapter 8. That shall be revealed inside of you. Come on, somebody. So you're to the pain and the pressure that you go through. Amen. You got to know that you are conceived in this 2022. It was predestined before the foundation of the earth that God had a pre-known plan about your life. Amen. You are pregnated with purpose. You are pregnated with destiny inside of you. And man tried to sabotage that. But I hear the Lord saying, what I have started in your life, I am going to finish it in your life. As you choose to partner with me, partner with my word, partner with the Holy Spirit, I believe that you will walk in a season of Galatians says, walk in the Spirit. Chapter 5, say, neighbor, walk in the Spirit. Say, walk in the Spirit. The Hebrew word for knowledge is the heart. D-A-A-T-H. D-A-A-T-H. Which is broken down to the word yada. Y-A-D-A. Y-A-D-A. Yada means to know as in seeing. To know as in seeing. Bible says you have eyes to see, but you can't see. God said, I'm showing you some things in the season, and a lot of us missed it in 2021 because we were too caught up with the surroundings and the happenings of life. We were too cold and crazy. And God is saying, but my son and daughter, I'm trying to reveal myself to you, and I'm trying to show myself to you. I've been trying to make myself relevant in you so that you can manifest me in reality. But you missed it. May you don't miss it now in 2022 in Jesus' mighty name. This is a divine apostolic prophetic dispensation that we are living in now. Glory to God. Glory to God. So yada means to know as in seeing. Right? As in recognition through a variety of senses. As in observation and care. And even friend. Famous, kinsfolk, or kinsman. We all know that a kinsman redeemer who gave his life that we might live. And that is Jesus Christ. He is our kinsman redeemer. Our Lord and our Savior. In other words, when the earth is going to be filled, it is going to be filled to the fullness with the knowledge of the glory of the Lord. The Bible says in Isaiah, remember Isaiah says, when the fullness of time had come. See, Jesus never came when he wanted to come. No, God sent his son at the fullness of time. And we ought to be operating in the full manifestation of Christ. Glory to Jesus. Amen. It's going to be full with the fullness, with the knowledge of the glory of the Lord. How many of you want that? Amen. But here's what you got to do. Empty yourself. Empty yourself so that you can allow God to fill you with his glory, with his knowledge, with his wisdom. The Bible says, when there's no vision, my people perish. What vision must you have? You must have a vision of God, and you must have a vision of his word. If you don't have a vision of God, and you don't have a vision of his word, you will perish. Praise God. He is the one who has saved us from our sins, who is Jesus our Redeemer, and reconciled us to relationship with God the Father by his shed blood on the cross. Praise God. So we ought not to be different from him in the earth. Because if you say that you are a Christian, then you ought to act like Christ. Be like Christ. Sound like Christ. Everything has to be connected to Christ if you say you are a Christian. The Romans called them Christians. They gave them the name Christians when you read in the book of Acts. They gave them the name because they saw them acting just like Christ. Come on, somebody. So if you say that you're a Christian, then you've got to act like Christ. This is where you've got to take introspect in your own life and say, Holy Spirit, search my heart. Psalms 139, search my heart, O God. Verse 23 and 24, search my heart, O God, and see if there's any wickedness inside of me and get it out. That's a daily process. We've got to say, God, refine us. Don't take yourself off the operating table, God. Refine me. Operate on me. Make me over again. scripture in prayer and in worship and desire to go deeper in God and say, God, I want to know you.
Am I helping somebody?
Amen.
Am I helping somebody?
Yes.
So you got to increase the level of the temperature of your waiting in God. This is what we must also ask the Holy Spirit to do. Holy Spirit, teach me how to wait. Because you see, sometimes we can sing the song, I don't mind waiting. And you tell people, I'm waiting on the Lord. But then God takes you through a longer period of time. Because he wants to teach you how to wait. See, sometimes we don't know how to wait. And here's the key. Here's the key for the breakthrough. Here's the key for the breakthrough. It's not just waiting on God. It's what you do in your time of waiting. You see, sometimes people can say, I'm waiting on God with the mouth, but in the time of the waiting, no, you're not spending time with God, you're not fasting, you're not praying, you're not going deeply in God, and you're not even going to the house of God. Hello, somebody. Social media cannot be your covering. Let's get that right. Glory to God. Okay, let's continue. The word glory in Hebrew is the word kavod. K-A-B-O-D. K-A-B-O-D. Praise God. Right? Amen? Amen? Alright, remember this is an apostolic prophetic fellowship and it's also a training center. So we don't just have to preach to hype you up. No, we have to teach you the word of God.
Amen.
We have, why? Because we have to be properly foundated in the truth of the word of God. Because how will you be able to resist the enemy if you are not full with the word of God? You're just going to be open to opinions and reasoning. That's the work of the enemy. Right? Praise God. So the word glory means in Hebrew, kavod, which means the weighty presence of God. This is what we're going to see in 2022. The weightiness of God's presence.
Amen.
Now you say, God, why am I going through this and why am I going to go through some of this? I'm telling you, you're going to go through some stuff. But let me tell you, it's to refine you. Listen to me very carefully. Don't complain. It's to refine you. It's to refine your character. It's to refine your behavior. It's to refine your nature. Praise God. What did I say on New Year's Eve service? The situations that we're going to go through in our process, it is part of your process, right? And what it's going to do, it's going to teach you. God is wanting to teach us to live above what we're going to go through. Come on, somebody. And when we learn how to live above what we're going to go through, then it's going to bring you out. Everyone had a process in the Bible. Job had a process. Remember, he was sold into slavery by his own brothers. He was thrown into the pit. Joseph had his process. Right? Moses had his process. Esther had a process. Jesus had his process. Right? Amen? Hallelujah? He had to go through persecution and suffering. Amen? And let me tell you, you have your process. I have my own process. But let me tell you, you've got to go through your process. You cannot jump out of your process. You cannot get a quick fix out of your process. There's no shortcut to your process. You've got to go through what you have to go through. Tell your neighbor, you have to go through what you have to go through. There's no other choice in the matter. Right? Because you all have an assignment and a purpose in the earth. So we're going to see what? The kabod of God. The weightiness of God's glory. What does that mean? It simply means, amen, amen. What does that mean? That you are going to be a carrier of God's glory in the earth. Now watch this. What? So you must understand this, beloved of God. The glory increases inside of you when you humble yourself. Number two, the glory increases in you when you don't give yourself any glory but God. You see, glory must always go to God. Glory is not there to make you hype yourself up and to make you a celebrity. No, that means nothing.
Praise God. In this season, you must be doing what God wants you to do. Am I right? Don't do anything else except what God has asked you to do. Don't say anything else except what God has asked you to say in this season. Praise God. And so the weightiness of God's glory, amen, amen, that God will just begin to heal people in the meeting even before the word has been preached. Even while the word has been preached, people will just be healed. People will be delivered. Amen. Amen. Demons will have to begin to flee. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. That's what I'm talking about. The weightiness of God's glory. Amen. Wherever you go, the glory of God. Watch this. The glory of the Lord attracts favor. Yes. Wherever Jesus went, sometimes he didn't even need to open his mouth. But wherever he went, why? He was the carrier of the glory of the Father. He says, if you've seen me, you've seen the Father. He says, if you've seen me, you've seen the Father. Why? Jesus always gave glory to who? God the Father. He never took glory for himself. God says, I share my glory with no man. God is going to use frontline leaders in this season who will share his glory with no man. No glory must go to man. Amen. God is going to expose man glorifiers who glorify themselves. Oh, it's because of me. Oh, it's because of me. It's because of me. It's because of me. No. Thank God for you. We honor you, but we honor the God in you. And we thank God for your life. Praise God. But glory must always go to God. But we honor. Amen. Leadership. Praise God. Is that okay? Is that okay? And I'm coming to a close. Praise God. So, kabod means the waiting presence of God. It also means the splendor. And it also means honor. It means splendor and it means honor. You see what happens? This is broken down to the word kabod. K-A-B-A-D, which means weighty in a good sense, numerous, rich, honorable, abounding, as in reference to nobles or nobility. We will know the fullness of our kinsman redeemer's weighty presence. Watch this. And his splendor and his majesty in 2022, when we come to know his nobility and bow to it in the earth realms. In other words, we begin to bow in honor. He says, I be lifted up. He says, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto you. The Bible says in the book of Psalms, let God arise and every enemy be scattered. This is a season where God has to be first priority in your life. This is a season where you've got to seek God first. Who? God. Right? Praise God. Amen. This is also 5782 is also a time to build the house for the future. This is a time to arise and build. Out of the ashes, you shall see beauty. Praise God. You went through many, many, many things, many challenges, many things that tried to suffocate you in your 2021. But I believe that you're coming out in this season. Amen. I believe you're coming forth in this season. Amen. And you're going to rise. Amen. Out of the ashes. Amen. And you're going to be that beauty. Amen. You're going to be that aroma of the fragrance of Christ. Amen. And you're going to do what God has called you to do. You're going to be what God has created you to be. And you're going to say what God has asked you to say. Hallelujah. Praise God. This is the season to arise and build. Amen. Amen. We got to build with God. Build on the word of God. According to Matthew chapter 7, he who hears the word of the Lord, amen, and applies God's word and does what of 2022, we all gotta take introspect and come back and say, God, I put you first in my life. God, I put you first in my home. God, I put you first in my situation. God, I put you first in my children. God, I put you first in my job. God, I put you first in the house of God. God, I put you first in the church. God, I put you first in my marriage. Holy Spirit, I put allow everything to take your place in my house and in my home, in my family, in the house of God. God must be first.
Yes.
Since I am I will draw all men unto you. Amen. Praise God. What I said to you, beloved of God, you must surround your inheritance. What is your inheritance? What Jesus has done on the cross for you. Come on, men will say it's not for you. Men will say that's not for you because they're looking at your outer appearance. They're undermining you. Hallelujah. But I pray in this season, may God connect you with people. Amen. Amen. That will begin to see purpose and destiny inside of you. Amen. May God keep you under the reign of your apostolic covenant. Amen. That will begin to cultivate purpose and destiny inside of you. May you discover that you are in a position and know that you are conceived. You see, you can't give birth if you don't know that you are conceived. Say, I am conceived. See, it doesn't matter what the woman might go through the pain, but she knows what is about to come. This is the season of your 2022 of giving birth to purpose and destiny. Amen, hallelujah. Amen, hallelujah. Some of you have went through some major pain, some major obstacles, some major stuff you've been through. But I believe that as you've been waiting quietly upon the Lord, I believe that God is going to launch you in this season. I believe that God is going to launch you in this hour. Amen. Amen. As God connects you with right people, and not just anyone, but when God connects you with people that are faith like mine, and with people that are led and governed by the Holy Spirit, and with people that have kingdom hearts, kingdom mindset, kingdom agendas, kingdom mindset. Amen. Amen. Not just be one of folks at church, one of these folks. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So surround your inheritance in this season, because the warfare is going to intensify as the enemy is going to do what? Listen to me. The enemy is going to try and oppose what you construct and what you secure in 2022. So as you're building now, as you're building with God, and you want God's divine accomplishments in your life, you've got to partner with Him. You've got to know His word. You've got to know Him. Okay? Right? So as you're building with Him, praise God, the enemy's going to try to do what? Oppose that. He's going to try and oppose the construction. So you're going to find the Peniners. Hello? I said you're going to find the Peniners. But Hannah was found in the presence of the Lord. And Hannah knew that she was seeking her face, seeking God's face. And I'm telling you, and I said this last year, while Hannah was seeking the face of God, listen to me, while Hannah was seeking the face of God in the house of God, that the priest said, this woman must be drunk. But she did not realize the level of intensity that she was willing to go in her aggression or her aggressiveness of pursuit in prayer, in the presence, in worship. The, oh my God, the effectual fervent prayer of the righteous availeth much. Not prayer. The effective fervent prayer of the righteous availeth much. That's what Hannah was doing. She was reminding God. And I'm saying to you today, you might have thought God has forgotten about you. And the promise, no. The promises of the Lord are yes and amen in Christ. And I'm saying to you, continue to remind God of His word. And you continue to knock. The Bible says, ox, oh my God, keep on oxing, keep on knocking, and keep on seeking. Tell neighbor, their neighbor, keep on oxing, keep on seeking, and keep on knocking. Don't give up. See, the enemy wants you to give up. He wants you to give up. And he used people to try and shut things in your life and for you to give up. But I say that nobody can shut the door that God opens in your life. According to the book of Revelation, said, I set before you a door which no man can shut. Amen. people. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. But it's all about responsibility to get our act together with God. Glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. 5:7-8 speaks of our conversation as a son of God. In other words, what we keep talking about ultimately reflects the content of our hearts. The Bible says, out of the heart flows the issues of life. Praise God. Some Christians are currently spending most of their time talking and thinking about COVID. Christians are becoming increasingly divided by conflicting COVID narratives. And behind it all lies an increasing level of fear that is affecting many hearts. I believe that the year 5782, the year of 2022 that we are in, teaches us that God wants our conversation to be dominated by faith instead of fear, by Jesus rather than by COVID. But to be able to change the word that we are speaking, we must first change what is filling our hearts and minds. If you are among those whose hearts have been affected by fear in the last year, I encourage you today, beloved of God, for you to take time away from the sources of fear in your life. For example, secular news, media, and social media. And dive deep into the Word of God. But the Bible says, I'm not giving you a spirit of fear, but a power, love, and a sound mind. Glory to Jesus. In other words, keep reminding yourself, instead of how God has protected you in the past, of His promises to you, as you make this your habits in this year ahead, amen, I'm sure of it that God will bring you through. God will bring you through. What does God require of us in the year 2022? Micah chapter 6 verse 8. Micah chapter 6 verse 8. What does He require of you? He has shown you, O man, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you to do? Justly, to love mercy, and to walk humble with God. That's what He wants us to do in 2022. To do what? Number one, to do justly. Number two, to love mercy. And number three, to walk humbly with the Lord. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. You've got to determine today that in this year of 2022, you've got to determine that as you discover your purpose and you discover what God has created you to be, because your surname is not who you are, your title is not who you are, where you live, where you work, where you stay is not who you are. Who you are is whom God created you to be. You've got to discover who God has created you to be. And once you discover who God has created you to be, then you can stand in the year of 2022 and stand and say that I am essential. I am essential. I am essential where you work. I am essential where you live. I am essential where you stay. Come on, somebody. I am essential. Right? In other words, when you say I am essential, okay, it simply means essential, the fundamental, it means vital, it means cardinal, mean, it means so important as to be indispensable. Essential implies belonging to the very nature of a thing. In other words, I belong to God. Right? And therefore being incapable of removal without destroying the thing itself or its character. So in other words, I am essential. So if no matter what life may throw against me, I know that I am essential because I am a part of God. What life throws against me, hallelujah, I am not moved. Negative doesn't have control over my life. People's opinions don't have control over my life. God has. God's word has the final say. That's what I simply mean, okay? It also means it is completely necessary or the part of the basic nature of something. So in other words, you need to realize that you are necessary in the earth. In other words, you are here for a purpose. You are necessary to be where you're working. You are necessary to be where you're living. Praise God. Hallelujah. Be intentional. An intentional manner means with awareness of what one is doing. In other words, I am aware of what I'm doing in my year of 2022. How many of you know what you want to do this year? I want to do what God wants me to do. Because I don't know what to do. And I don't know how to do it. God knows. So what I'm going to do? Trust Him. The Bible says, be not on your own understanding. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 and 6. Be not on your own understanding. It says, trust the Lord with all your heart. Be not on your own understanding. But in all your ways, acknowledge God and He will direct your path. You got to partner with the Holy Spirit, not because we just cross over. No, no. You got to partner with Him daily. Partner with Him daily. Praise God. I said, partner with Him daily. I said, partner with Him daily. Romans chapter 4, verse 17. And this is your desert, and we are done. Amen. Glory to Jesus. Romans 4, verse 17. Amen. If you dare say amen.
Amen.
If you dare say amen. I'm going to paraphrase it for you what it simply means as you underline it. Okay? I'm going to paraphrase it. It simply means, speak those things that are not as though they were. That's what you got to do in 2022. What you got to do? Speak those things that are. In other words, what is that is the are? What is that? The written word of God. The promises of God. Amen. Amen. I'm going to speak that promise. I'm not going to believe the report of the doctors. I'm not going to believe the report of man. But I'm going to believe the report of the Lord for 2022. Hallelujah. Amen. And so as I believe the report of the Lord, I'm going to speak what the word of God says. Amen. When man says negative, God says yes. When man says no, God says yes. When man says you cannot do it, God's word says you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. This is the year that we must speak. But don't just speak anything. Don't run your mouth. Wait on God's leading to speak. So you know what to speak, and you know how to speak, and you know when to speak. Because some people don't know when to speak. This orders when they yap, 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 yap. The Bible says, be quick to listen and slow to speak.
Yes.
That's why some people say, but Apostle, why are you not speaking? No, I want to hear what you say. I'm quick to listen and I'm slow to speak because I must only speak when He tells me to speak. Hallelujah. Don't go running your mouth. Speak when God tells you to speak. Amen. Because when you don't do it without God, you're going to speak and speak until your face is red and blue, and speak and speak, and nothing's going to happen. Because God says, I was not involved in that. And Holy Spirit said, I never need you to say that. Don't go prophesying. And if the Holy Spirit did not tell you, because then you are prophesying. Amen. The Bible says in the book of Job 22:28. Whatever you decree, so shall it be done. And the favor of the Lord will shine upon that word that proceeds out of your mouth. Make sure that you are in right alignment with God in this season, 7 days a week, 24/7, not just on a Sunday or a Wednesday prayer meeting, on a Tuesday night or Friday intercession. No, 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 don't play around church. Don't play with church, okay? Don't play with God. Bible says God cannot be fooled, He cannot be mocked. Alright, we gotta get serious with God, we gotta get right with God, we gotta get into alignment with God, we gotta come into alignment to God and His word, we gotta come into an agreement with God. How can two people walk together unless they are in agreement according to Amos 3 verse 3? Come on somebody, right? So we gotta get into alignment with God. If I want God's divine accomplishments for my life, I've got to come into alignment with that which He has in store for me. So I've got to get to know Him. And I discover what He wants me to do, what He wants me to say, where He wants me to go. Because I don't want to do anything without God in my year of 2022. And all the days of my life, God willing. Am I helping somebody? So what do you have to do? Speak those things. Right? Those things that are not as though they were. That is faith! Not fear. We must stop speaking fear. We must speak faith. Amen. For faith is the substance of things hoped for, Speak the word of God. Speak good seeds. Sow good seeds. Don't speak curses. Don't speak luck. And don't speak karma. Speak blessings. Say, neighbor, speak blessings. You still find some believers. Oh, do you know karma? No, I don't want to know that. Do you know Jesus? Do you know God? Do you know what the word of God says? I don't want to know that, and I don't want to know luck. No, it's only by luck he made it. No, it's by the grace of God. It's by the mercy of the Lord. Amen. It's because of God's goodness. Because I found my place to be with God. And a place prostrate before God with a repentant heart, confessing to God, yielding myself to God, and allowing God's grace and mercy to carry me through. Bible says in Lamentations chapter 3, because of the Lord's mercy, that we are not consumed. So I challenge you to speak life. When you are led by the Holy Spirit, you will speak. You will speak what's on the heart of God. That's why God said, Ezekiel, can these dry bones live? Ezekiel 37. Can these dry bones live? See, God already knew the answer, but God just wants you to see, where was the prophet's mindset? Where was his heart? Today, who's important what you believe? God said, Ezekiel, can these bones live? Ezekiel says, Lord, you know the answer. You see, sometimes we gotta come to realize we don't know it all. I have not arrived. Paul says, I have not apprehended. In other words, I have not arrived. Never come to a point in your life and say, I've arrived. I've made it. No, you haven't. Always remain humble. Always remain empty. Always allow God to fill you. Always decrease or he increases. Die to self daily. Never live with pride, because you will fall. Mm-hmm. 2022 speaks of double. And 22 comes from Isaiah 22, verse 22. Am I helping you today?
Sure.
Come on, I said we've got to have strategy. Okay? This ministry is led and governed by the Holy Spirit, not by man. Right? We're not going to follow the routine of the world. We're going to follow what God's word says. Amen? Amen? Remember I said, for God I live, for God I die. 2022, what? For God I live, for God I die.
Yes.
Amen? Praise God. So God make me over again. Isaiah 22:22. I will place on his shoulder the key to the house of David. What he opens, no one can shut.
Amen.
Come on now. What he opens,
yes,
no one can shut.
Hallelujah.
And what he shuts, no one can open.
Oh, yes.
Come on. Are you excited? Can you see how much? There's so much of goodness in the word of God. He says, what he opens, no one can shut.
Yes.
And what God shuts, no one can open.
Yes.
The Bible says, God shut the door of Noah's ark. And no one could get in. I'm saying to you today, get into God. The Bible says, seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon his name while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his unrighteousness. Find God. Run to God. Run to God. Run to God. Father, I just worship you this morning. Come on, let's just worship you. Just worship you. Just worship you. Just open your mouth and just worship you. Just worship you. I decree and I declare that in 2022, when God opened the door in your life, that no man can shut. Divine accomplishments. Divine accomplishments. Divine accomplishments. Divine accomplishments. No man can shut that door. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And every man-made door that's been opened in your life, I pray today that God shut that door. In Jesus' mighty name. Karabase kede de boshaka. Rakasa kate kede. Lokasa tama. Kerabakaso to. Say, Lord, fill me up. Lord, empty me and fill me up. Fill me up with your presence. Fill me up with your glory. Fill me up with your anointing. Refresh me, refresh me, refresh me. Lord, make me over again. Amen. Come on, for God I live, for God I die. Makasa tare de sheke. Come on, if you can pray in tongues, pray in tongues. Come on, open up your mouth and pray in tongues. Come on, open up your mouth and pray in tongues. Open up your mouth and pray in tongues. Don't let the moss stop you from praying. Come on, what the Bible says, the effectual fervent prayer of the righteous availeth much. The effectual fervent prayer of the righteous availeth much. Come on, say, Lord, put faith up. Increase my faith up. Pray today, may the Lord increase your faith. May the Lord increase your faith. May the Lord increase your faith. That you will speak faith. You will speak the word with boldness, with authority. May the Lord increase the level of your hearing. That you will hear God accurately. Amen. Hallelujah. That you will respond to that situation correctly. May God increase the level and intensity of your hearing. That you will hear God. May God anoint your mouth. May God anoint your lips.
Let the King of Glory come. Don't say anything, just be quiet. Just say, God, I want your glory. I want your glory in my life. The Bible says even when David committed a sin, David went before the Lord and he confessed and he cried out to God and he repented. And he said, God, I want your glory back. I want your glory back. You might have made some mistakes. You might have fallen along the way. You might have done things on your own account and your own thoughts, your own understanding. But say, God, I'm coming back to you. I confess my sins to you. You have an advocate with the Father this morning. Hallelujah. Reach out to God and say, God, I confess my sins to you. But the Bible says, only God knows the heart of man. Only God knows the heart of man. Only God. So God, I surrender my heart to you. Lord, you can have my heart. Tell him, you can have my heart. Lord, you can have my heart. I surrender it to you. I surrender it to you. Make me over again. You are the potter. I am the clay. Make me over again. Mold me, Lord. Shape me, Lord. Use me for your glory, Lord. I want to be used for your glory, Lord. I want to be used for your glory, Lord. Lord, I've been wrong. But God, I'm coming to you now, my Father. My Lord, my Savior, my King and Redeemer. I'm coming back to you, my Father. I'm coming back to you. Who is the lover of my soul? Jesus! The lover of my soul. Love me this morning, Jesus. Love on me. Love on me. Love on me. Teach me how to love. Teach me how to love. Teach me how to walk in love. Release fresh anointing upon my life. Destroy every yoke of bondage in my life today. In the name of Jesus. Yeshua HaMashiach Hallelujah. Yes, indeed. It won't be long now. This is God's decree to you, to the remnant, to the ecclesia. Things are going to happen so fast. Your head will swim. One thing fast on the heels of another. You won't be able to keep up. Everything will be happening at once. And everywhere you look, you'll only see blessings. In the name of Jesus. Blessings like wine pouring off the mountain and the hills. God, the Lord of God says, I'll make everything right again for my people. My people Israel, I will make things right again for you, says the Lord. God, the Lord says, for my people, they rebuild their root cities. They plant vineyards and drink good wine. They work their gardens and eat fresh vegetables. They plant them and plant them.